Welcome everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk, and today we're going through the accessibility options and settings that we're going to find on the Xiaomi Mi Mix 3 5G version to make sure this device can be used for you no matter your ability and what options you need to change and adjust. So let's hope it has everything you may need. So it's a large display as well, first of all, which I want to point out. It's a 6.39 inch display, and I always like to have a large display. It is 5G, but that's not really going to be much of the option today. We don't need to talk about that. So first of all is the volume key shortcut. So this works during the setup phase and it should work now. So if I press both together,
talkback on system launcher.
Now we're on our home screen here, and talkback will talk back everything to you no matter where you want to touch or highlight. So you can start with your applications and then it will give you options once you've paused on one.
Phone, messages, Chrome, camera, my Vodafone. Double tap to activate, double tap and hold to long press.
So it gives you an option there. Also, when to navigate, use two fingers, swipe across, then again.
Start, messaging, cleaner, notes, Instagram, weather.
It will narrate everything to you. That even works in the taskbar up here at the top.
11:37, battery 92%, 92, 4G phone signal full.
So it will tell you everything. Really great feature. Really pleased it's on this device. Should work really well. Thanks to the partnership of the Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 processor, 6 GB of RAM as well. So it shouldn't have any issues to help you whatsoever. Really pleased to see that on here. And really pleased to see that it was in the setup process as well. Only that was the only option, was the volume key shortcut. There was no dedicated accessibility option. But really pleased it's on here and it works.
Talk back off.
Pressing and holding will turn talk back off. And as you saw, it put a watermark on here that you can turn off, and we'll have a look at now. To find the rest of your settings, what you need to do is jump into the settings application here. As you'll notice, I've got a dark theme on mine, a little bit easier to read and just a little bit easier to see. And you can change this and I'll show you where that is. So inside settings, you need to go to additional settings and then come down to the bottom near enough. And then four from bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4, you've got accessibility. So then finally, you're in your accessibility. So the one little let down here is it's quite buried in the actual menu systems. I wish they brought it forward maybe just one step, or mainly just on the main settings page, as we see from the likes of Samsung, iPhone and other Android users. It just seems to be a little bit buried here with the Mi UI 10. Again, something that they can change and highlight in the new Mi UI update. So once you're in your accessibility options, you have different things to go through. First of all, at the top is your volume key shortcut. So inside here, you've got different options that you can choose and change. So you can select any one of these options to actually be used instead of talkback. I think that's a really good thing to have there. Again, you can turn that on or off depending on your choice. When it's first launched, the talkback series will give you a tutorial to go through everything you need to know about. Underneath that is an accessibility menu. So inside here, this will give you a menu to toggle on things without coming into the settings application. Really good thing to have. So toggle on here. So once toggled on, you should get an accessibility person down here, or you should get an option down here. Sadly, with the Mi UI 10 and the Xiaomi Mi Mix 3 5G and other Mi devices I've previously tested, it seems like there's been a software issue where this hasn't been implemented. This is the same on other people's devices, and even with updated software, still issues here. Don't know what's going on. I'm really looking into this, really trying to find out why this option isn't available to us. As you've seen previously, you do normally get another icon down here with our three capacitive touch buttons, but sadly there's nothing there. But that would give you a menu then to use to highlight different accessibility options. Underneath that is talkback, so you can go inside here, look through talkback. You do have some settings again that you can change and adjust here depending on when you want it, if you want it to read everything. So quite a lot of detailed settings here that we haven't seen too much on previous devices. So this is a really good thing. It's just a shame some of the other features are potentially not working. Another option is select to speak. So select to speak is slightly different. This is when you toggle on, press OK. Again, you'd get an accessibility man here. You'd press this, then you tap here, and then it would just read the text to you. It wouldn't read everything. So it selects the certain things that you want it to actually dictate to you or narrate back to you. Again, a great option. You do have some settings again inside here that you can turn on. So if I turn even both of these on, come back. Again, that option should be there, but it's not there. Really frustrating to see here. So underneath that, you have text-to-speech output. This is where you can change your language, your speech rate, and then your pitch, so I can make it really fast.
This is an example of speech synthesis English.
So really fast there. Some people understand that. Or you can slow it right down, and then you can change this as well.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
So it really changes and adjusts. You can press the reset here and it'll go back to its default options. Nice to have on there, just shame them options are not there available currently at the moment. Coming up underneath that, you then have display size. So you have some presets here at the top and then you can change. You can make it larger or even bigger. And then you can come down the other way as well if you want to. If you want to make it smaller, you don't have to have it the way you want it. You can make it the way you want it to be for yourself. So coming back, as you'll notice, a little bit bigger here, and then I can read through a bit more. So magnification, so you have magnification by tap. So 1, 2, 3. 3 quick taps will zoom in. Large display here, an AMOLED panel, so it looks really rich and the text will look really nice and easy to read. 1, 2, 3 to come back. Also, there is the other option, as you know. 1, 2, 3. Hold on the third one. Maneuver with one finger around your display. Then when you release that, that will zoom back out for you. Again, good option to see on here. Also, there's magnify with button. So toggle this on. Again, you'd get an accessibility option down here. And then you tap where you want to zoom. But obviously that's not usable because it's not working. Frustrating yet again. Underneath that you have color correction. So you can change and adjust the color correction depending if you need to. And again, it gives you a couple of options here, 3 different options here to change and adjust if the color correction is a potential ability changing problem for yourself. Underneath that is color inversion. So if I toggle this on, it's going to turn it slightly different. So this is different from light theme to dark theme. So if I go home here, you see the whole colors are washed out and completely different. They're completely inverted. So tap the menu button here, go back home, toggle this off. So this is what it looks like then in dark theme, go home again. You can see the differences there between the two options. But that is there to help someone if they potentially need that. Then you have a large mouse cursor. So you can use a mouse cursor for this device. And that's where you use your switches and your interaction devices. And you can use a cursor to manipulate your way around your device. You then have remove animation. So if you don't want the animations, you don't want all the fancy bits, that's fine. That could be removed for you, and that's not an issue then. Underneath that is one very important setting that I do like to see here, and that is switch access. This gives you the ability to use switches and different interaction devices with your phone. So once toggled on here, you'll be asked to go into settings, and then you can link up different interaction devices that you may have. So if I just come back out here, turn this off, but that's an easy way. And like I said in a previous video, I want to actually get some of these devices and see how well they interact with the phones and make sure the phones are actually doing the functions it says it can do. Obviously, you have a load of different settings inside here that you can change and adjust depending on which switches and which interaction devices you are going to use with your smartphone here. Again, really impressed to see that option on here. Quite a new setting that we've seen in the last 18 months, 24 months. So I'm really pleased to see that. You then have dwell timing. So dwell timing is for when you're using a mouse cursor and when you actually stop moving is to the point of when it will make a click or an action come true. Again, a nice option to see on here. Again, quite a new option that we've seen in the past 12 months. Your power button can end call. So your power button is on the side here, the right hand side, just underneath the volume controls. Underneath that, you have auto rotate screen. So depending what way or orientation you have your display, this will change for you and make it quite easy to enjoy content, sit back and enjoy. Touch and hold delay. So you can change this here if you want to. Again, this is for dexterity and interaction abilities. You can change and adjust that there depending what options that you need. Underneath that, you have vibration. So you have ring and notification vibration, depending if you want it for when the phone rings or when you receive a notification. Then you have touch vibration as well. So when you actually touch and highlight something on your display, you'll get like a feedback option. Underneath that, you have the ability to use mono audio if you want to use mono audio. Then you have captions. So I like captions here. Once toggled on, you have different options here to change your language, your text size. Like I said, you can change and adjust that. Also color preference as well. Really nice to see different options on here. Captions would be used if someone has a hearing ability. Then at the bottom, you've got high contrast text. So if you look at the titles here, you'll notice a difference. Everything comes a little bit more bolder, a little bit more easier to read. So depending on what options you want to use there, you have a nice range of options. There are some more settings hidden in a different section as always. Not every company has got it right. They do like to put them in different areas. So if we now move into display, which is up here in the main settings option, you've got your brightness level. First of all, you can change and adjust your brightness level here. Inside here, you've also got night mode brightness and then also night mode color temperature that you can change and adjust there. You then also have reading mode. So reading mode, if I toggle this on here, will sort of make it yellow, a little bit easier to read, and it won't be so bright and vibrant blue in your face when you're reading at nighttime. You can schedule that on or off, and you can adjust down here at the bottom depending. And as you can see, that harsh sort of blue light is actually dimmed there, if you can see it. Again, a very good option to have here. Really pleased to see it on this device. Underneath that is contrast and colors. So this is where you can change your display and change it depending on what options that you want and how you want your display to work for you. It's a good option to have here, and I'm really impressed to see that you can actually change it so much and actually make it what you need it to be. Underneath that is ambient display. So we can toggle this on. So an always on display, and we've got our clock here. You can add different things depending what you want. So you can have this, different colors, which is really nice. It all depends what you want it to have. Then obviously it will give you notifications as well. Really pleased to see that on there, because I receive so many different notifications. It's good to just have a quick glance at my phone before potentially then picking up and seeing if there's anything interesting. So then it comes into dark mode here. So if I toggle this off here, it then goes to a very standard white background with black text. I prefer dark mode. It's just so much easier to actually use here with a white text on a black background. Just makes it so much easier for me to use. So one option that's a little bit hidden here is text size. So you can change and adjust your text size, which makes it easier for you to read depending on your ability again. So coming back home, that's all the settings that you're going to find there. To start off with, let's talk about the elephant in the room, shall we? It's still not working. The option is still not there, and I really don't know how to fix it. I have spent hours researching and looking into Xiaomi and the Mi UI 10. Some features work for some people. I've talked to two other people that have the Mi Mix 3 5G version, and theirs don't work either. So they've got it on potentially different options, different settings, and they've tried it for me and it's still not working. So this is a real highlighting issue if you are looking at this device, but you do have ability that you need to change and adjust the settings for you to use this device easier. Please, please make sure that you spend your time to look into this device, making sure you are going to be okay with it, because I have yet again had issues with this device. I had it with the Mi 8 Pro, and like I said, other people are still having issues. I believe it is software related, always believe it's software related and easily fixed. I just don't know the right people to talk to. So if you do, can you please share this with them? Highlight it, share it on Twitter. I really do appreciate it, because there is a potential issue here that is going wrong with the software and it needs to be updated so all these great settings can be used for anyone to use their device no matter their ability. On the other hand, there are a great amount of settings on here. There are so many different settings and so many different sub-settings inside an option that you can go through, change and adjust to make it easier for you to use no matter your ability. But if you need them key highlighting ones, then potentially you might need to wait for a software update. Really impressed, looking forward to using the phone, and I'll come back during my review and highlight if I have fixed it at all and actually talk about the accessibility features that I've used during my testing time. In the meantime, if you have any questions or queries about the Xiaomi Mi Mix 3 5G, please drop a comment down below. You know I'd be more than happy, as always, to help. A massive thank you to Vodafone, who has sent this out for us to review, and it is on their Vodafone 5G network. I'm just not in that area as of yet. If you have enjoyed this video, please support the video by giving it a like. Also, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to the channel and ring the notification notification bell to stay updated. We have just surpassed 15,000 subscribers, so massive thank you to everyone who is a subscriber and watches and comments on my video. I really do appreciate it. From me, Ricky, and the Xiaomi Mi Mix 3 5G, I will see you very soon. Bye for now.